Fung, Superintendent Lunsden, administrators, parents, and most importantly, students. Thank you for being here this evening to celebrate our students' accomplishments. Mr. Kelly is right on the money when he says Cranston East is very special to me. I started my career in Cranston here in 2001 as the assistant principal at Cranston East. And as I moved up the food chain, so to speak, Cranston East has always remained very special to me. So every time I come here and every time I'm asked to speak, it means a great deal to me. I am honored to represent the school district this evening. And I'm honored to celebrate all of your accomplishments. This evening, as Mr. Kelly was speaking and talking about parents entrusting us with your 5-year-olds, and now we are giving your 18-year-olds back to you and to society as young adults who have done amazing things. I looked at the faces of the students, and some of them were scared, and some of them were sad, and some were very happy. But all of those emotions are correct this evening and then again on June 6th. It is a bit scary to be turned out into the world today. You leave Cranston High School East, which has taken good care of you over the past 4 years. You may be leaving your family, your homes, and moving on to college. But I can assure you, you are well prepared. And the reason I know this was a twist of fate this afternoon. My son, who is in the 4th grade, decided to have a little bit of an asthma attack today because of all the allergies and the pollen and stuff in the air, which normally he doesn't do. So I swiftly picked him up from school and brought him to the pediatrician, where he ran up the stairs to the pediatrician's office. So I think the asthma had abated by then, but we sat there for an hour, and by the time the doctor came in, he brought in a physician's assistant in training. And she walked in, and he introduced her, and he said, "I hope you don't mind, I have a physician's assistant in training. Do you mind if she joins in on the appointment?" And I said, "Of course not." And I looked at her, and she was a 2007 graduate of Cranston High School East. And I looked at her, and I said, "Hi, Kayla." And she said, "Hi, Miss Bella, how are you?" And then she looked at my son, who I was pregnant to, while she was here and I was here, and she said, "Oh, wow, he got really big." I said, "Yes, he does. You keep feeding him, and that's what happens." So it's always funny because something like that always happens on the night of convocation. I always have this kind of signal from somewhere up above that all of the good work you do and all of the good work your teachers do really is worth it. And I know the media and sometimes politicians like to say that we are not doing good things here. I challenge them to tell me any different, especially on a night like tonight, and especially on June 6th when you all cross that stage. So I looked at Kayla today, and I said, "All right, there's my sign that all of your hard work and all the hard work you will do over the next few years will pay off. You will do amazing things, you will become amazing people, hopefully you will come back to your community with all that you have learned and do wonderful things for your neighbors, your friends, maybe some of your teachers. Maybe you can be their caretakers in the future because we're gonna need it. So again, just consider all the hard work that you have done and will do to be worthy of your time, your efforts,